Hi guys, welcome to part 2 in this lesson where we are trying to figure out interesting ways to play any scale, be it major or minor or anything, ascending and descending, and train our rhythmic sensibilities and our ear and our musicianship while doing so. So the second way involves different compartments or different groupings of notes. So normally when we play a scale going up or anything for that matter, when we divide beats, we tend to divide either by 2 or by 4 or by even numbers. So that's pretty much our mindset while doing stuff. So if we go G major now, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and... we're pretty much dividing by 2. But you could try dividing by 3 or working your way with triplets and not altering the movement of your hand. It just keeps going up and down, but you're trying to do or feel 3. Let's see how that sounds and then I'll break it down. One triplet, two triplet, 1 2 3, 1 2 3, 1 2 3, 1 2 3, 1 2 3. It almost feels like a completely different melody, right? Just because my mind is thinking 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Of course, it'll be more obvious if I do. But I don't want to make it this obvious because it should also be an exercise to kind of hold your ground with the scale, you know? Just not change that or not alter that pathway. So you go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So you could count it in triplets and perhaps play one of the three in your left hand and start with a simple note like the G, which is the root. 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And it doesn't really resolve or sort of recycle very soon. It's going to take a long, long time for it to actually come back to where the starting G with your thumb was in fact at the one of the bar, which is quite cool. So 1 2 3, 1 2 3, 1 2 3, 1 2, finally ended there. And yeah, you could do some chords. One triplet. Right, so that's a triplet feel. And you could try all sorts of other groupings. If you want to try groups of 5, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. You can do all these groupings and try to hold your shape. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Or you can even count 5 as 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, or 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, right? To break up the 5 even further. Right. So the second way which I wanted to mention to make this major scale a lot more interesting, just in that ascend and descend, is to do it over different accents. And you have a ton of opportunities in the left hand, if you're a pianist, to kind of embellish with chords, chord changes at the accent points, which would have otherwise been at very different points. Otherwise, we think in even numbers like 2s and 4s. So you should definitely start off by doing it with triplets and then try out other accents as well and see how it goes and hold the same shape. You're still going pretty much up and down. That's pretty much it. Right guys, so moving on, join me for part 3 where we are going to discuss a few, join me for part 3 where we are going to discuss yet another really cool way to play your major scale or whichever scale up and down and have a lot of fun while doing so.